Hi guys, it's me again, Aswad. And sorry, I've been not going getting my reviews up early because I just got a new job. So I was focusing on that. And secondly, it's a festive season here in Malaysia. So I just, you know, busy with work and then coming back for holiday and stuff like that. Anyway, I'm going to do a review for Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom. Jurassic World 2 Fallen Kingdom. my opinion about this movie, you know, I've always been a fan of Jurassic movies, Jurassic Park, since Jurassic Park 1, even the bad ones, you know. But for me, this movie, you know, because this latest one, it has special effect, it's great and amazing. But most importantly for me, it's always been the story. If the story is great, it affects me, then it will always have a better score, even though the special effect is not that good. But you know, special effect with Jurassic movies has always been amazing, so there's no problem there. This movie actually has two parts. The first part is them going to the island and saving the dinosaurs, and two is a haunted house kind of movie where a dinosaur get loose inside this house, big house, and they have to survive. So it's more like a haunted house kind of story. When I say it's part one and two, it reminds me of The Lost World. The Lost World, which is the second movie of the Jurassic Park story movies, where at first part one is they go into the island to see some dinosaur and rescue some dinosaurs, and then part two is the T-Rex got loose in San Diego. So it's kind of like that movie, but I have to be honest with you, this movie is not as good as Lost World, and to me this movie is not as good as the previous movie, Jurassic World. And why do I say that? Because there's not a lot of character growth, you know. I find the movie is very much have a television feel. It feels like a television story, especially the second part, the haunted house movie section, feels like a haunted house kind of movie, and that really it really does feel like a TV show. So it really didn't excite me as much. And then you don't have an iconic dinosaur like the they have the Indoraptor, which is like the mix of the Indominus Rex in the previous movie, and you know, but in a smaller size. And then the Indoraptor got loose and stuff like that. I wasn't impressed, I wasn't scared as much as the previous movie, the bigger one. I always love huge big dinosaurs, so this one have a smaller one. I really wasn't that scared for the characters. The Indoraptor was not that terrifying for me. And then they have these human villains, which really is out of place. You know, I wasn't really interested in that kind of movie. But I know some, a lot of people will like it. But I also don't like the characterization. You know, in all of the movies, people, they start in A and then they end up at point B, and then they change along the way. Even in the first Jurassic World, you see Chris Pratt characters change drastically, and then you got the female character, you know, Bryce Howard Dallas character change, you know, from somebody who was so uptight to somebody who was more relaxed and more, you know, more open-minded about dinosaurs and not just use them for money. You got those characters change in the Jurassic World movie. In Jurassic World 2, there's no character growth for anybody, so there's no surprise, you know. Their characters still remains from at point A, they start at point A, they end up at point A. There's nothing change in their characters for me. And then they have introduced this little girl who turns out to be a secret thing in the movie, secret twist. But she's annoying, and I don't get any characterization from her. She doesn't have a lot of lines, and you know, she's okay, but wasn't as good as the kids in the other movies. Even though I don't like Jurassic World 1 so much as the other Jurassic Park movies, but I still can watch that movie more than once. I actually watched that movie 2 times. But this movie, I never had the desire for Jurassic World 2 to rewatch it again. Simply because there's nothing exciting, there's nothing interesting for me, except for the first part. The first part I like a lot, where they go to the island, they want to save dinosaurs, they interact with the environment. I like this kind of thing when it's outside. You know, they have wide angles, you can see the beautiful island of Hawaii where they shoot it. I like those kind of thing where they are in nature. But unfortunately, it wasn't that long. It was cut short. I wanted more. And I wanted the ending for this movie to be the ending that they showed in this movie, in the first part of the Jurassic World, where they left the island. It was kind of sad and touching. I wish that was the ending. But they put in the second part, which is so... It was shot indoors. It was shot in the giant house. And for me, it wasn't as interesting. It felt like a TV movie. It felt like something shot on TV, because a lot of indoor shots and stuff like that. That means the company wanted to save money or what? I don't know, but that's the effect of the movie on me. I really wanted to love this movie, but I didn't. It was just a CGI fest. You just see the dinosaurs and that's it. The other part I liked about this movie, the flashback scene between Owen and the raptors. I love those kind of it's really shows more character depth for the raptor Blue, and I like that. I like that part. I also like the part when they're trying, the enemy, the bad guys, trying to take some data from the island, from the old broken park, and then they unleash the sea dinosaur, open it, and that dinosaur escape out into the sea. That is a better movie, you know. But the rest of the movie was like, oh lama, it wasn't really exciting. Especially, like I said, the last part inside the house was really underwhelming. That's my score for this movie. It's quite underwhelming. I wish it was, you know, I really wanted more with characters, human characters. I think the strength of the Jurassic Park movies, besides this dinosaurs and the CGI, it's always been the character. You always remember Jeff Goldblum. You always remember all the female actors, the actresses, Muldoon. You remember all these characters. Human characters is important in a movie, and the first Jurassic Park has a lot of wonderful characters. As you remember Jeff Goldblum forever. And you also remember the dinosaurs. But in this movie, in Jurassic World 2, there's very weak human characterization. And I miss that, you know. But I know a lot of kids will love it. But this movie is really not made for kids, because it's a lot of people getting killed and eaten. CGI is fantastic. The movie feels like a television show. That's my review for Jurassic World 2. Thank you for being patient with me. I just got a new job, so I'm you know, focusing on my new job, and then, you know, trying to get this video, my YouTube channel, get to a better level, you know. Got a new job, I can get money and get better cameras and stuff like that. Anyway, thank you. Hopefully you enjoyed this movie. If you do, just smash like, subscribe, and follow me for the next videos. And thank you guys for watching. Peace.